Well, welcome to Pen and Flakes. This introductory session is just letting you know how the lakes were formed, why they're there, and what people do with them. So basically, in the first step, you've got to work out where the lakes are. And the lakes in the first place are west of Sydney, about 50 or 60 kilometres from Sydney west. This is part of one of the most growing areas of the Sydney region. And what most people don't understand is the size of Penrith Lakes. It is absolutely massive. People just think that the Penrith Lakes were made for the rowing for the Olympics. That's not correct. Penrith Lakes occupies that area of land in yellow, which is 2,000 hectares. I know, 2,000 hectares, that doesn't mean anything to me. But basically, if you think of it this way, if you're on the Harbour Bridge and you were here, and you took a boat trip up the harbour, you end up at the top of this map, and it's at Manly, or North and South Head. The total area of Penrith Lakes is the same as Sydney Harbour from the Harbour Bridge to the Heads. So it is much bigger than most people tend to realise. So just have a look, we can see what goes on here. What activities? Coming up right now. That's the Nepean River, which goes through Penrith. Oh, big boys' toys, they're everywhere. Big boys' toys. If it wasn't for big boys' toys, there'd be no Penrith Lakes. That's just an aerial shot. That's an artist's impression of what the lakes look like. And that's the main rowing lake and the island. The boats in this particular case are called dragon boats. It's one of the races that they have here on the rowing. Oh, look at this. We've got here rowing, and there I am in my younger days, and there I am again, just doing a little bit of canoeing. Oh, fantastic. Not him. Oh, that's not me. That's Jessica Fox. Everybody should know Jessica Fox. She was at the last Olympics and won gold. There I am, just in here in the raft ride, Whitewater Centre, and there I am doing my daily exercise. Yeah, busy person. And here I am setting up the boats, ready to go sailing on the warm up lake. And of course, I'm driving this. We're testing this one. That's good fun, that one. But what you've got to realise is there's areas around the edge of Penrith Lakes. This is Waterside. It's a residential development. Be aware that the water from Waterside runs into Penrith Lakes. This area is also very historic. It's got a very good... When the first fleet came out here, they needed food for Sydney, and this is one of the places they grew food for Sydney. But we're not concerned today looking at the history. We're more concerned about what goes on here and how the lakes are formed. That's what you have to do sometimes. Get in some kayaks and have a look at what's in the water, what's in the lakes and the river. Some of the activities we do with the younger students and the older students is jib netting, finding out what's living in the water. This gives us a guide to water quality. There's some serious HSC students. We get lots of groups early on the year doing science. All right, but what you've got to understand about Penrith Lakes is why it is here. Penrith Lakes in the first place is not about recreation and having fun. Penrith Lakes in the first place is about something you like, what I like, the teachers like. It's about money. If it wasn't for the fact Penrith Lakes could be, we could extract things out of the area and make money, they would not exist at all. We'd have no Penrith Lakes at all. And it's all about one thing. Big boys' toys. Yeah, there they are. There they are. I have this because the tyres on this truck, in real life, are taller than the roof of this building. And do you know, one tyre on this truck is worth $6,000. And there's six tyres on the trucks. So it's $36,000 just to change the tyres, apart from the rest of it. So basically, for 25 years, they've been digging here to make money. And do you know what? I ask all students who visit here, I say, what do you think they're digging for to make money? And do you know what they tell me? Gold. And I said, I wish, as a poor old school teacher, I'd be out there digging myself, get the gold out. No, Penrith Lakes, not quite as interesting as gold, but what they're digging for to make money is this. Yeah, rocks. Yep, they've been digging for 25 years, digging rocks out of the ground. And they're really clever. The people who do this are big companies, big companies. Yeah. And what they realise, when they dig these rocks out of the ground, they realise they're dirty. So guess what they do? They wash them. Yeah, good idea. Yeah. And do you know what? Not only that, they worked out that this rock here, look at that one, now look at this one. They worked out all by themselves that that rock is actually smaller than this one. Yeah, you're pretty smart, hey? Yeah. And then what they do, after they wash them and they sort them into sizes, they take them to a factory and they smash them up. They call it crushing. And they worked out if you get a big rock and you crush it up, you end up with lots and lots of little rocks. And this is what they sell. This is the money. I'm not talking millions of dollars. I'm talking billions of dollars that come out of here. And do you know what? Your school helped pay for these tires, truck tires, because your school bought thousands of dollars of this. Thousands of dollars of these things. And your school didn't know quite what to do with them. So they had a meeting. They said, what are we going to do with these? And they decided they'd get these and they'd glue them back together. Yeah, they glue them back together. Yeah. Have a look. There you go. Look at that. All little rocks, all glued together. All together. Look at that. Oh my goodness gracious. Oh, see that? They get the rocks, they get some sand, they get some water, and then the glue they use is cement. And that makes concrete. If you've got concrete at your school, then you've got Penrith Lakes at your school. Not only do they make concrete, but they also get tar. And when they get the tar, they glue the rocks together with the tar, and they make roads. So if you've ever travelled on the M4, the M7, all of those roads, they're made from materials that came out of Penrith Lake. So get the idea. They were digging holes to get gravels and sand, and then make roads and concrete. And that's the reason why. So how long were they digging for? When were they digging? Let's have a look. We can see that they were quarrying here. That's the word. It's a quarry from 1980 to 2015. In 2015, no more materials were coming out of here. And that let them start to fix more of the lakes up because they don't want to leave a big hole in the ground. Don't want to leave a big hole in the ground. So what did it look like in the first place? In the first place, we had this type of thing, whereby the layers, you can see we've got in the first layer up here is topsoil, then there's soil and silt, there's the money. And then down the bottom is a flat rock, totally different rock like that, which is called shale. So we've got these different layers were originally there. They had to get the sand and gravel out. So that meant they had to dig down. And they certainly did dig. I've got to apologise to you though. Look, when you hear this sound, don't worry about it, all right? When we're doing this, I wanted to try and make this a little interesting presentation. So everybody loves the trucks. Everybody loves the trucks, they're great. So after a while, when I stop talking about trucks, I start talking about rocks, and rocks to some people aren't quite as interesting as trucks. So look, forgive me, will you? Please forgive me. What I did to try and liven up this slide a bit, I decided that I'd pretend that I was a truck, and when you hear this sound, don't worry. All it's doing is pretending that it's dough, the material, and we're left with a big hole in the ground. Okay, here it goes. This is what happened to Penrith Lakes once they dug out all the sand and gravel. Oh, yeah, sorry about that. I do apologise, that's all right. But you get the idea. It's all gone. We're left with the shale. We've got a big hole in the ground. And people from Sydney said, what are we going to do with all these holes? And my one suggestion was, we'll turn it into the biggest tip in Australia. Let's fill all our rubbish, all our waste into these holes, make the biggest tip in Australia. No, that's a silly idea. Because Penrith Lakes is on a special feature, a special what they call a geographical feature. And that feature you've heard of before, it's called a floodplain. It is very flat. It floods here. And you can't put a tip where it floods, because all the materials that you put into, all that waste, all those paints, everything else, would then wash in a flood into the river and ruin the ecosystem of the Hawkesbury Nepean River. So no, they said, let's not do that. Instead of that, let's do this. Let's establish ecosystems, and let's have plants, animals, and a place where people in the future can come for recreation. They can paddle, they can swim, they can come and have picnics, they can go for walks, they can ride a bike, they can do all these other things. Yeah, that's a better idea. Yeah, a lot better idea. Yeah. So, the idea behind the lakes, why they're here, is to provide, and it's a very big word, a sustainable area for the future. A sustainable area. Something that can be used for future generations. So that gives you the idea. What is it going to look like when it's finished? My goodness. Here's an artist's impression, but I've got to tell you that it's just about like what you see there. It has been created. And the lakes have water in them. We have a big lake for sailing, little beaches for people to go swimming. We have other lakes here for recreation. We have a special wildlife lake. We have a lake for competitions, for rowing and other things. And we have a series of lakes here and over on the far side there, which are protection lakes. They protect, they're called detention basins because they hold back the water that flows in here to stop the dirty water getting into this straight away. So we've got a whole series of lakes. The housing that they're putting there is maybe, we don't know yet, we'll find out in the future whether they're houses, but just think about the fact that it is a floodplain. So there may not be too many houses on this area, but we'll find out in the future. So that's Penrith Lakes, a place for you to play in the future.